Breakfast Martini with the Portobello Road Gin. So when I first started to think about the recipe, I wanted to bring out the perfect serve. And when you serve Portobello Road, the perfect serve is with a twist of grapefruit. So I've used that as the key citrus in the drink, and I've made a grapefruit curd to go along with it. So one of the things that I like to do with gin is bake. So I wanted to combine that with the cocktail. So in here, I'm just going to pop a 50ml measure of the Portobello Road. And what Portobello Road are really good at, so it's all about the history of the gin, but they don't obviously forget about contemporary, keeping up with trends. So one of the things that they did recently for St. George's Day was a take on British cocktails. So I tried to bring, sort of using Portobello Road and the history of the breakfast martini, into sort of a trend by using a grapefruit curd, so using different ingredients. So I've popped 50ml of Portobello Road into the cocktail shaker. I'm going to pop some Cointreau in there as well, which is one of the ingredients that is used in the breakfast martini. Okay. I'm also going to pop 25ml as well of lemon juice in there. So these are the traditional ingredients that you find in a breakfast martini. And sort of my new take on that with the grapefruit curd. I'm going to pop just a really good measure of the grapefruit curd in there to bring out the citrus and give that a stir. Just going to pop a little bit more in. Because Portobello Road's a juniper heavy gin, it balances well with lots of citrus, hence why we're going for citrus. Give that a shake. There's a couple of reasons as well. So a couple of reasons why I picked the breakfast martini. Breakfast because I like to drink gin for breakfast. but also when I do shake the cocktail shaker, I look like I've been drinking gin since breakfast. So that's sort of one of the reasons. I give it a really good shake. I've got some ice in there as well. And I'm just going to double strain that where we've got all the bits that we need. Get into a cool martini glass. There's also a joke in my family that limbs are not very good. I always sort of like, my arms seem to flap around, so a bit awkward, but hey ho. Okay, so I'm just going to strain that in there. You can add egg white to this. If I was going to use the traditional sort of ingredient, which is a marmalade, I would have used an egg white. But because I've used the curd and it gives it sort of a bit of fluffiness, I've opted for not using an egg white in this. And then I'm just going to express some of the grapefruit over the top. Okay, and I really love flowers, it looks really pretty. So I'm going to garnish now with some edible viola. Ooh. And there you have it, breakfast martini.